Hi there! In case you are a web developer, probably you have already heard about Node Express, or you have even already utilized that. So I decided to bring in this video 5 hints about things that are quite useful and maybe you don't know. So let's explore each of these topics. The first functionality we are going to see is the clear cookies method from the response object. With a single method, it will handle the whole cookies exclusion from the user browser. Now, imagine this situation. User has an authentication screen and it could store in cookies if it wants to keep connected or not. In case it keep connected, it's going to create here one cookie variable like we are going to see here. Okay, in this case, now we have a cookie variable named current user that is an existing cookie, and we want in the logout functionality this cookie to be deleted. So the native way for doing that with HTTP protocol is like we have here programmed. It's using the setCook as a response code saying that one specific cookie name already has expired, and then send that as a response. We have no cookie anymore created because the browser will be automatically responsible for deleting this cookie. However, we have just this clear cookie method. That's a native method from the response object from Node Express. So just by calling the clear cookie, it's going to create this message automatically, and it's going to be triggered when we log out the application. So please let's then observe here in the browser that now let's also here clear the requests we may have. So then we could have a full evaluation about what we're going to happen. So log out. What happens when we have clicked in logout? We probably has received here a lot of methods in our response headers. And one of them should be set cookie. As you can see here, the set cookie variable sets the current user variable as a red expired variable, 1st of January 1970, so it has automatically set the first available date, and then now the cookie is already deleted. So as you can see here, the clear cookie is some kind of shortcut for one similar code to this one. So basically, Node Express do nothing new as the HTTP protocol already does, but it makes that easier to us in the backend programming to perform that. The second thing we are going to see is the static method from the Express object. This static method allows we define a set of files that can be accessed directly by URL without we have to program anything. It's like a public directory of files we can store directly in our web server to be accessed by users and applications. The static method is here defined. You can set that very near to the creation of the app object from Express. And then here we set as a parameter the name of one folder inside your project you would like to deliver the files as a public file, so user can access directly by the URL without need it to be delivered as a programmatic response that you have to do by coding. So here I have one public directory, and inside this public directory I have then one login screen for user to be authenticated. So the idea here is that once we have, let's return to code, once we have set this directory as public, we do not need to worry in the access about these variables. So actually, when we perform one request, then to this specific port I have defined, the file already will be accessed directly here. And then it's all kind of files, not just HTML, but PDF files, also image files, or any other kind of files you would like to deliver, CSS files, JavaScript files, and so on. So in this context, in case we open here our browser, you may see here that we can just access the login screen directly by URL. Okay, we have then here, I have already programmed some redirect right coding for send for that when user access directly the root of the server, but this file here is directly accessible. So it's very useful and you can achieve that just with some kind of definition like this one. The third one, the redirect method from the response object. It will automatically handle the 301 response code from HTTP to send the response data to the user based in one web page or any kind of file accessed by a web browser. Now let's see the redirect method from the response object. So what it does? Actually, in case we do not use that, we have to use it by the native HTTP protocol that we set the redirect code from the 300 family of response code. We have to inform the location attribute with the address we would like to redirect, the login screen. In this case, we would like to redirect the user. The idea here is if the user accesses the application, but it has no cookie that identify the user, so it's going to be redirected to the login screen. In case we know the user, it could be redirected automatically by the requested URL, having then the private content to be delivered. But then here, we could automatically replace these three lines of code by this redirect line of code that's going to redirect the user request to this point. But of course, in the background, this three line of code is also executed. We just do not see that. So now let's experience that. In case we open here again our application, and then let's try access here the, let's first go to our network tab and see what happens when we clear here the whole history. And now let's access the root entry of our server. See what happens. The local host has received our message and it has answered with 302 code saying that there is a redirect. And then it also has to inform in the response the location attribute to login HTML. So actually the things we have defined in code here, saying the response code and the location and then sending, is also done by the redirect methods, do exactly the same thing. But then we just say redirect and it automatically handles the adding of the location we want to send the user and also to set the status code. So very useful for situations like this one, which we identify what should happen when user access the application being or not being logged in. The fourth one could be a little bit polemic, and it's so because we are talking about rendering HTML content in backend and then deliver that to user. So the idea here is to use the render method from the response object. It will give to us the possibility to use some kind of HTML file as template and replace some parts of the code by JavaScript variable. And then just after everything is replaced, it returns the dynamically HTML code produced to user interface. So let's see it now. As a good web developer, you may know that when we made a request to a server and it delivers a response with a screen. It sent to us the HTML code produced by the backend. So here, in case user has input the right credentials for the application, so we are going to send the administrative area. We are going to show the private content to this user. Okay. Without support of any additional method, we basically need to build this HTML in our backend to be dynamically created. So it's necessary codes like this one. Okay, in which we build here HTML code, replace some parts of the code with variables, and everything is right. However, it's not so good for programming because we have no support of IDE or things like that, because here there's no autocomplete or so on. So we are inside a string. So for access that, there is the render method. The render method gives us the possibility to take one template of HTML file, and here the object to be utilized as basis for replacing variables. So we don't need to build any more strings for computing the HTML content. Here we then has one folder named views. Okay, it's necessary, I'm going to explain to you. And then here inside is the HTML template. Here we have the code of our page, and here the JavaScript variables that needs to be automatically replaced. And this replacing is done automatically by the render method. We don't need to program that, so it's safe of errors. And then return to our code. Here then I have a variable named username, and the value of the variable is login. So when it says in template it wants to render username then is here and it's replaced. And how it works, what you have to do to have it working for you as well. So it's basically the following. You have to call, of course, the render method, and then here the name of the template you would like to be processed and delivered as the HTML content. So the name you set here in the left side needs to match with the name of your file here. And for it start to working, you need to do the following. You need to install this library here for the JavaScript working with this view engine, right? So you need this first line of code here together with the installation of this package with your npm. And just that. By doing that, it will expect a views folder in your project, and the first parameter of the render method that it's here will expect the name of a file that is inside. So that's the way it works. We are going to set the login and the password, and then we are going to be redirected to this specific page in which we show the username, the logout option, and the download of manual for user. So here, in case we return to application and now again set here these credentials, we have this content here that was created by the render method. So we have variable here, and we have variable here as well, in which we're going to explore in the last hint. Now the last one, this is very useful. Imagine you have some kind of private files stored in your web browser, so it should not be public available to users. But depending of the response, depending of the user, its authorization, you may decide to deliver this file to user. So we are talking here about the sendFile method from the response object. This method gives us the possibility to take any file of the file system of your web server and send that as response to your user, and of course perform some kind of previous processing before delivering the HTTP response with this data as content. Okay, this last hint is my favorite one. It's quite useful. Suppose this file here is not exactly public. We have to, this PDF file here, we have to show that just by users that are authorized. So what we are going to do? When user clicks to see the manual, it wants to download the manual, we are going to perform some kind of login. We are logging here in the console, but could be in one database, could be in anywhere. And then we could compute in case it has downloaded already, it has some kind of pre-requirements to perform this download. So it's very interesting. This folder is not public accessible, so users could try to build a URL and trigger that in browser to download this content. It's not public accessible, but using the send file, method, we may inform the full path for this file in our backend, and then the on server access this file and deliver the content to user already building the whole headers and everything according with the file type that's defined here by the extension. So now, in case we open here the console of our server, let me here clear that. In case we clear that here, let me just also stop that, run that again, then we have here a clear execution of our server. So now let's do the following. Let's log in and then try to download and see the code run through this part and this manual here being delivered to our user. So here is the user screen. Let's do everything from beginning. User is going to authenticate and now it is authenticated. Let's see here the console again. Here we have some kind of message that gets some things to be corrected in this project. Let's clear that. And now let's try to download the content. Download manual. As you can see here, it has downloaded the manual. It's here just as one demonstration file. Okay, it has downloaded that. I think maybe it has not presented here to us the response content it gives to us. Let's explore that. Ah, here it is. Application PDF. So as you can see, this send file method, it handles the headers, header length, head contents type, the contents length, contents type, everything related to this specific file. So we don't need to worry to build these header stuffs. The send file method performed that to us. And the main purpose delivered this file that's private access to user. So the nice thing of that, you can use that together with database and have not the files already ready to be consumed in our backend web server, but could be also in another storage of files that also is not public accessible and your web server do the process for handle when it should display or not display this file. So that was the 5 hints I have to give to you about Node.js Express. Thank you.